Hi all, today again I am here with all of you, and again our topic will be related to COVID for sure. Today I'll discuss two subtopics. One will be the black fungus, because people are asking what should be the diet, you know, what should be the precautionary diet, or you know, just what should be the dietary guidelines for this black fungus. So first I'll answer this. We don't have any, you know, I don't know about black fungus much, but I have seen so much of fungal infection post transplant, because I've been a part of a big transplant team for so many years. And after transplants, if the patient's isis stays prolonged, see, I'm not a doctor, I'm just telling you what I have seen and what I have observed. So we were seeing a fungal infection in wound, like if the patient's isis stay was prolonged. And after transplants also, people get so many steroid therapy. So why I'm correlating everything? Because I have seen some fungal infection after transplant with definitely a steroid therapy. So in this COVID also, this very clear, people, what we are listening actually from the panel of doctors, the discussions are going on, and what we are observing also, because of prolonged hospital stay and more steroid therapy only, we are getting this black fungus. And it's not that common, and it's not for everyone who is getting this COVID infection. So people has to be very light, you know, people are very tense, like, okay, fine, COVID came and now maybe the black fungus will also impact us. Nothing like that. Everybody who got COVID, they're not very prone for this black fungus. They have certain, you know, like basic guidelines that we have to follow, and only particular kind of patients they can get this black fungus. But yes, definitely we have to be very careful if at all we have any comorbidity, like basically diabetes. So we don't have any dietary guideline for black fungus as such, but only one thing I'll say, if at all you are having blood sugar, try to control your sugar. And if at all you're not also having this sugar also, try to cut down all sort of simple sugar, and you know, try to limit the simple sugars consumption, and try to have a high protein diet, as already I said, and try to limit simple carbs. That's very important. And if at all you're diabetic, you have to be very careful. Your blood sugar should be definitely in range by hook or crook. That you have to take care, and you take help with the doctors and dietitians definitely, but you have to control your blood sugar. That's very, 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 very important, I'm telling. If at all you want to know about a diabetic diet, you can please talk to your dietitian, and she'll tell you, it's not a rocket science, believe me. You can control it very easily with your lifestyle modification, only diet and physical activity, and you can do it very well. Definitely medicines are important, but because I'm a dietitian, I'll talk about more of this lifestyle modification. So for black fungus, we don't have any dietary guideline, but you have to cut down simple sugar and simple carbohydrates. And if at all you're diabetic, you have to take care of your blood sugar by hook or crook. I don't want to comment on someone, but I have seen some videos on YouTube by famous hepatologist or hepatosurgeon, something she is. With all the due respect, I really want to say, ma'am, if at all you're not a dietitian, please try to avoid talking about it, because what you are telling is not having any scientific evidence. You can check about the video, and I really want to talk particularly about the video, because the video says stop all source of carbohydrates, eat only proteins, and believe me, that's not the way. You have to limit carbs, but you have to take some sort of complex carbohydrate, and all the carbs are not bad. Similarly, all the fats are not bad. Similarly, all the proteins are not useful. It should be a balance. Think about your office, where one day you're going to office and you're wearing only shirt, and one day you're going, you're wearing pant, and only one day you're going and you're wearing only tie. Imagine, it's just like that. So that's over. And now second thing, people are telling the second wave will hit the children more, and people are getting again paranoid about what our children should eat. And believe me, social media is getting flooded with all sort of videos. So I'll tell you only one thing, when you were a child and when I was a child, have we ever thought about this? Never. And did you meet any dietitian at the time? Never. So let it be. Let the children eat whatever they like. Definitely you should be the role model. If you will eat healthy, definitely your child will eat healthy. And take care of your physical activity. So definitely your child will try to copy you. they are actually copycats. If you will do some sort of physical activity, they'll also do, they'll also follow you. If you will limit your social media and gadget time, definitely they'll do the same. So you have to take care of overall psychology of your kid in terms of being a good role model. You eat healthy, your child will copy you. That's only important. Eat only homemade food. And yes, definitely for the timing, try to eat maximum homemade fresh food. Avoid outside eating, avoid ordering food from online portals, if at all, it's not that mandatory. Okay, follow all such of all such rules what your government bodies are telling. Wear mask, hand hygiene. Similarly, same thing your child has to do. Okay, if at all your child is not getting exposed with sunlight, you can think about vitamin D supplementation, but after discussing with your pediatrician. So we don't have any diet particularly for COVID in children. We don't go for any this immuno boosters and something this. Please don't go, let them eat healthy diet, homemade diet, and try to be the role model for them. They'll copy you for sure. And it's okay, relax. The third wave will come and we'll face that also, don't worry about that. But yes, we have to be cautious, we have to be aware, we have to be quite be your own judge. Try to assess each and everything, but without losing your hope and without losing your calmness. Stay calm, stay relaxed, nothing will happen, don't worry. Thank you so much. If at all you want to ask something about your, see, if your child is having some sort of disorder, like existing disorder, like they are asthmatic or they are having type 1 diabetes or maybe they are having some other normal flu or infection, some allergies, at that time you have to be very careful. At that time you have to talk to your dietitian about particular diet about those type of comorbidity disorders. I won't say comorbidity, sorry, those type of disorders, whatever your child is having, specific medical condition, that time you meet your dietitian and ask about the diet. But that will be for that, not for COVID precaution. Don't worry, your child will manage everything. They got better immunity after 5 years. They got the immunity, their immunity is really good. And if at all they are below 5 years also, don't worry, nothing will happen. Just try to give them a well-balanced diet, take care of their hygiene, because they are not that aware. You have to teach them about personal hygiene, okay, oral hygiene, hand hygiene, everything. And nothing will happen, don't worry. You can ask your questions in the comment section about anything. And if at all you want me to discuss certain topic also, please do write. I'll definitely try to make a video on that. It was a very short video because I wanted to cover this very important topic. And we'll meet again. Thank you so much. Take care.